Once, there was only one man in the world who believed in God. And he taught his family to believe in God. And his name was Noah. Everybody else lived wicked lives and laughed at Noah because he believed in God. God grew angry when he saw how wicked the people were. And he said to Noah, "Build an ark. Build it big as a great ship, so that it can float on the ocean. Build it long, build it wide, and build it three stories high." And Noah and his three sons built the ark. They built it in the field behind their house. The people laughed to see them building the great ark so far from the ocean.
Noah built an ark, working hard from dawn till dark. There's no water anywhere, but Noah doesn't care. Noah, two by two, turned his ark into a zoo. As you find them room to fit, careful, Noah, don't get bit.
After many months, the ark was finished, and God said to Noah, "Go into the woods and the hills and the swamps and bring back a pair of every kind of living thing that walks on the earth and crawls on the ground and flies in the sky. And gather food for them and food for you and your family. Enough food for a long, long time." And Noah did what the Lord told him, and soon there was a line of every kind of living thing crawling and creeping and slithering and flying and walking and running and leaping into the ark.
As the animals marched into Noah's ark, people gathered on the way. For they had never seen before such a wonderful display of spots and stripes and feathers and fur and paws and claws and scales and horns and hoofs and trunks and beaks and flippers and tusks and tails. There were lions and tigers and bears walking along in twos, canaries and eagles and collies and beagles and rabbits and kangaroos, giraffes and cats and pandas and bats, walruses, elephants, gnus, buffaloes, beavers and bees, fireflies, foxes and fleas, hippopotamuses, also rhinoceroses, chipmunks and chickadees. All the animals marched into Noah's ark. They came from far and wide. They took their places in the ark, and all you could see inside was spots and stripes and feathers and fur and paws and claws and scales and horns and hoofs and trunks and beaks and flippers and tusks and tails. Spots and stripes and feathers and fur and paws and claws and scales and horns and hoofs and trunks and beaks and flippers and tusks and tails.
The people laughed to see Noah leading the animals into the ark.
Noah! Now that you've built your ark and got your passengers, where are you going?
Noah, you and your family get inside the ark where you will be safe. I am going to punish all the wicked people in the world. I am going to send down a great flood in which they will all drown. And Noah and his family went into the ark and locked the door behind them. And the heavens opened up, and it rained, and it rained, and it rained, and it rained. The rain flooded the ground and lifted the ark off the ground, and the ark floated higher and higher and higher. And still it rained.
It rained for a day, it rained for two, it rained for three and four. It rained and rained and rained and rained, and then it rained some more. It rained and rained and rained and rained, and then it rained some more. It rained for a week, it rained for two, it poured and poured and poured, till only Noah's Ark was left and those who were aboard. Till only Noah's Ark was left and those who were aboard. First the water covered the ground, turning it into mud. But that was just the start of the great big flood. It covered the fences, the barns, and the trees. It covered each city and town. It covered the hills and the mountain tops, and still the rain came down. It rained and it rained, it splashed and sloshed, it splattered, dripped and dropped. For 40 days and nights it rained, and then at last it stopped. For 40 days and nights it rained, and then at last it stopped. First the water covered the ground, turning it into mud. But that was just the start of the great big flood. It covered the fences, the barns, and the trees. It covered each city and town. It covered the hills and the mountain tops, and still the rain came down. It rained and it rained, it splashed and sloshed, it splattered, dripped and dropped. For 40 days and nights it rained, and then at last it stopped. For 40 days and nights it rained, and then at last it stopped.
After the rain had stopped, the ark floated for a long time until it came to rest on the top of Mount Ararat. Then Noah waited in the ark until he thought that the water was gone. He sent out a raven to see if there was any dry land. But the raven did not return. Noah waited 7 days, and then he sent out a dove. The dove flew and flew, but found no place to rest her feet, and came back to the ark. Noah waited 7 more days, and sent out the dove again. This time the dove returned with an olive branch in her beak. Noah waited another 7 days and again sent out the dove. The dove did not return. Now, Noah knew that the water was gone. He opened the door of the ark, and the sun streamed in. The great flood was over. And the Lord said to Noah, "Never again will I send down a flood to destroy the world and all the people in it. I make this promise to you and to all who will come after you. Whenever you see this sign, you will remember my promise." Noah looked up and saw a rainbow in the sky.
Why does the rainbow come after the rain? In case you didn't know, God sent a flood, a terrible flood, to punish the world long ago. But after the rain was over, and after the flood was done, God made the rainbow as a sign. Thank you. rain was over and after the flood was gone, God made the rainbow as a sign that he